was in Nicholas's room. I know he's not here, but I wanted to sort of follow up on that cover story and ask you, is he somebody that sort of has been integral to your development? Do you look up to him, model yourself after him, anything like that?
Yeah, I mean, I think ever since I started watching NHL over here, he's been one of the guys that you always been watching and always wanted to be like him. And I still do that. He's one of the guys that you kind of follow and see how he handles certain situations and what he does out there is pretty amazing.
What stands out most about his game for you?
No, I mean, I think his consistency. I think every game he seems to do the same things over and over again, and it seems to be working over and over again. So he's a smart player out there. I mean, I think the way he reads the game and the way he sees everything, I think he's really good at making those fast decisions about everything.
Do you see any of you in him?
No.
Him and you, sorry?
No, I know. I mean, I think we're in a way, maybe we're similar, but I think we're different players. I mean, obviously, I would love to be like him and being able to play the game the way he does, but I mean, I gotta try and do it as good as I can to ever be being able to be recognized as a player like him.
Eric, the competition that race with Marian Hossa, was that a fair competition? I mean, you had 12 years on him, I think.
Yeah, he probably outweighs me a little bit, but I mean, he's a fast player, and I think in the game, he's one of the fastest out there, and I think that's what it's all about. This is a fun thing to do and really see how you skate, but I think with the puck and in the game, he's probably one of the fastest skaters.
It's a good match for you.
Yeah, I mean, I think so. I didn't have a puck this time. If we have a puck, it's probably a different story. He's an awesome player. I mean, he's a great player, someone that also been a big part of me starting to play hockey and watching hockey, I think. To be able to race against him was pretty good.
Is this more fun than it was the first time?
I mean, it's different. Obviously, last year it was my first year. I was there alone. I didn't really know anyone, and I was probably a little bit more nervous around everything. I didn't really know how it works, and this year I think I'm a little bit more laid back, and can really suck in everything that's good, and enjoy it every second that I'm awake, basically.
Thanks, Erik.
Thank you.
Jumping in a bit late, Erik. What did you think of some of the moves that were pulled out tonight? Sorry if you've answered this already, but saw the Superman cape, saw the mini stick. Anything that you preferred over the others?
There's a lot of good things out there, I think, and it's hard to single out one. But I mean, Kane took a pretty safe bet there, and chose to go with Superman. And if you read his comic books, it's pretty hard to stop.
And obviously, with you being here last year, is there anything that was unexpected for you this year, or did it live up to all the hype that's been put around the weekend?
I think so. I think everything has been great so far, and we still have one more day to go, and I think it will be even more amazing tomorrow, and everything around it. I think it's been really successful, and I've been downtown and seen everything down there, and it's really nice to see how much effort this city's put up to make this happen and make it work.
What did you think of that ovation that Alfie got when they did the introduction?
I think it was very special. He told me right before I stepped out. I stepped out right before, and he said, "Enjoy every moment now, and have as much fun as you can." And I think same thing goes for him. I think the fans and the crowd and everybody gave him every opportunity to be as happy as he possibly can be. And I think that's what he is right now. And it's nice to see that. Everybody here really appreciates what he's done for the team, the organization, and this city as well. And it's something that's very well deserved.
Like, do the rest of you that are here from the Senators, are you happy to see that, what you just said? Just to see him get this?
I mean, I think everybody that's close to him is really happy for him. I know I am. I mean, I couldn't wish him anything else, I think. And to be able to be here alongside with him and see all this, and I mean, you just feed off the joy he has right now, and he really, really helps you understand how big and how much fun this is.
What are some of the biggest lessons you've learned from him since you've been here?
I mean, it's a lot. It's pretty hard to single out only one, I think. The kind of guy he is, even off the ice, is pretty remarkable, and something that I can only wish to be when I'm his age. And I think, the things he's been through and his experience has made me maybe mature a little bit faster and making me realize that some of the things that I need to do to be successful here, and especially off the ice as well. I think he taught me a lot of good things that I didn't know before I came here.
Do you spend a lot of time with him off the ice, or?
Yeah, I mean, we have a good relationship. I think my family and his family as well. I think his family is really good, and it's always been to me and my fiance as well. I think they really been taking care of us in any way that's possible, and if there's ever anything you need, you can always pick up the phone and you'll know they'll be right there for you.
Erik, as you look forward to tomorrow with the All-Star game, is this a matter of just being loose and having fun, or are you guys going in with any particular plan more?
I think it's both. I mean, you gotta enjoy yourself, and I think that's what we're going to do tomorrow, but I think we're still going to try and put up the best fight we can.
Thanks so much.
Thank you.
Was there anybody that really surprised you tonight? Like, when you're watching some of the passing or the shooting, you get to see these guys in game situations at full speed once or twice a year, but was there anybody that you just stopped and said, wow, that was incredible?
I mean, I knew Hagelin was fast because I played with him before, but that it was the fastest guy, that was probably a great thing, I think, and it made me very happy.
How much did you know about Daniel before you got here? Can you explain what his reputation is in Sweden? And did you know sort of his connection with the city before you got here?
Yeah, I mean, I knew he was, for sure. He played in Finland during the lockout, and that's probably when everybody started to realize how good he was and what kind of player he is. And I can say I knew him on ice hockey before I came here, that's for sure. And I mean, I have a lot of friends that know him as well, and everybody's been saying the same thing, and that he's a great guy.
Separate subject, your I mean, where do you think, I mean, obviously your offensive numbers have been incredible, but do you think you've made strides defensively as well, and what are you proud of in your game?
Yeah, I mean, I think the experience is probably a main thing in everything, and just being able to play more games and develop all the time has probably made me a better hockey player, and hopefully keep doing that, and that's probably the main reason for everything.
Did you come in with certain goals or certain things you wanted to work on, and have you exceeded them?
I mean, the season isn't over yet, so obviously my goals aren't done. I mean, even if you reach one, you're always setting a new one, and there's still a lot of things to reach up to.